Hello dear students, my name is Andriy Vakulenko, I am your Ukrainian teacher, and in this lesson we are going to talk about genitive case in Ukrainian language. Родовий відмінок в українській мові. I hope you have watched my videos about other Ukrainian cases, locative, dative case. So, genitive case correlates with the questions. Кого? Чого? Repeat after me. Кого? Чого? Кого? Чого? Let's look at the function of this case. The first function of genitive case expresses the relationship of possession. For example, книжка вчителя. Книжка вчителя. Батько Катерини. Батько Катерини. As you can see in English, at first we say the name of a person, Катерина's father. But in Ukrainian we can say батько Катерини. Вікно матері. Вікно матері. Mother's window. The second noun in such expressions denotes the owner and takes the form of the genitive. Okay. Let's look at the second function of this case. Genitive case indicates that one noun relates to or otherwise describes the other. The first noun is in the nominative and the second is in the genitive. Let's take a look. Проблема життя. Проблема is in the nominative case. Життя is in genitive case. Майдан Незалежності. Майдан Незалежності. Here it's the main square of Ukraine, of Kyiv city. Майдан Незалежності. Незалежності is in genitive case, and in the nominative case it will be just Незалежність. 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 Так, ми зараз борімося за нашу незалежність. The third function of genitive case. When affirmative sentences with a direct object in the accusative are negated, the direct object takes the form of the genitive. For example, наприклад, Марія має книжку. And let's take a look when negated form. Марія не має книжки. Марія не має книжки. Another example. Роман пише лист. Роман не пише листа. Сестра їсть яблуко. Сестра не їсть яблука. Try to create your own example with this function of genitive case. And write down in the comments. It will be interesting for me and for other learners to read and to discuss. The fourth function. The genitive is frequently used to express a point in the past, present, or future with nouns described by the adjectives. Наприклад, цей, той, минулий, наступний, кожний. Such adjective plus noun expressions of time are simply put in the genitive singular. Memorize these typical expressions of time in the genitive. Let's pronounce these expressions. Цього тижня. Цього. You can see this soft sign. And this letter, ц. Ц. Цього тижня. Цього тижня. Того року. Or just торік. Торік. Минулого понеділка. Минулої середи. Кожної суботи. Наступного разу. Цієї п'ятниці. Тієї весни. Наступного четверга. Наступної суботи. Кожного четверга. Кожного разу. Good, let's move on. Let's take a look at formation. Утворення. Nouns, іменники. The nominal genitive endings. Ü, A, U. Ü is taken by feminine and masculine nouns ending in A. Книжка. Без книжки. Книжка. Без книжки. Is taken by feminine nouns ending in two consonants. Молодість. Після молодості. Після молодості. Молодості. And ü is taken by the group of baby animal nouns with suffixes at, yat, en. Курча без курчати. Ім'я без імені. The next letter ending a is taken by all consonant and o ended animate masculine and all neuter nouns of hard stem. For example, брат, it's masculine. Без брата. Авто, без авто. Also, this ending a is taken by a smaller group of frequently used inanimate masculine nouns ending in a hard consonant. For example, словник без словника. Автобус без автобуса. And let's take a look. Ending ya is taken by the animate and inanimate masculine and neuter nouns ending in a soft consonant. Now we can easily define this soft consonant, yeah? Вчитель без вчителя. You can see this ya ending instead of soft consonant. Олівець без олівця. Де твій олівець? Я сьогодні без олівця. Okay, let's continue. The inanimate masculine nouns that take the a, ya ending include days of the week, понеділок до понеділка, четвер до четверга. Also, these nouns that take the a ending include names of months, вересень, січень, від вересня до січня. Also, the names of flowers and trees. Тюльпан без тюльпана. Соняшник без соняшника. Also, names of the cities. Київ до Києва. Чернігів до Чернігова. Let's move on. The stress in the genitive singular is mostly identical with that in the nominative singular and is relative to the order of syllables. It means that if the last syllable is stressed in the nominative singular, the last syllable stays stressed in the genitive singular. Even if in absolute terms it is not the same vowel. Let's take a note about the stress in the genitive case. For example, Василь без Василя. The stress stays on the same syllable even if the specific vowel stressed in nominative singular vanishes in genitive singular, as in листок без листка, кінець без кінця. This occurs in words with a stressed final syllable. And now let's do some practice. We need to practice this knowledge, yeah? Треба практикувати ці знання. And now I have this interesting exercise where we must say there is no and to put this noun in the genitive case. I will show you how to do this and then you must do it by yourself, on your own. Самостійно. So, say, there is no, тут немає. In Ukrainian, тут немає. Зошит. Зошит. We need to put this in the genitive case, because now it is in the nominative case. Зошит. Тут немає зошита. We add this letter, this ending A, because зошит is in the masculine singular. At first we must define the gender and type of noun. Зошит is a noun in masculine singular. In genitive case, in masculine singular, we add consonant A. So, зошита. Тут немає зошита. Так, try to make with this word. Good. The next word. Село. Тут немає села. Тут немає села. Тут немає місця. Місця. Because місце is neuter singular. Good. And one more word. Бабуся. Бабуся. Good. Let's do another exercise. We must put the pronouns in brackets into the genitive case. For example, у друг є собака. Друг. Ukrainians don't say like this. У друг є собака. Because we must put this noun, друг, in the genitive case. У кого? У друга є собака. А в тебе є собака? Write down in the comments. Окей. У Джон є наречена. У Джон. Джон – it's a name of a man. So, masculine, singular, we add ending A. У Джона є наречена. А у мене немає її. А у мене її немає. Окей, the next. У дівчата є гроші. Дівчата. It's plural. У дівчата є гроші. We don't need to put ending here. У дівчат. У дівчат є гроші. Good. And now a bit harder task. We still need to put pronouns in brackets into the genitive case, but there will be two words. For example, сьогодні Майкл має урок українська мова. Українська мова. It's in the basic form, Ukrainian language. But we want to say that today Michael has the lesson of Ukrainian language. And that's why we use genitive case. Сьогодні Майкл має урок української мови. Мови. Мова. Мови. You can see this feminine singular, мова. We change the ending from A to I. And українська, it's adjective. We change this ending to ої. Української. Try to do this by yourself. Я люблю вірші українські поети. Я люблю вірші українські поети. Українські поети. You need to put this into the genitive case. It's time to finish this lesson. I hope it was interesting and useful for you. Keep practicing, and also you can support my channel on Buy Me a Coffee and Patreon. I will make a post there with the table of these endings, so you can learn them easily. Also, write down what other topics you are interested in, what would you like to know from Ukrainian grammar or culture or other topics. Thank you for those who are supporting me, and keep praying for Ukraine, because now we have no electricity. Every day, authorities, they turn off electricity for like 5 or 6 hours. Of course, it's really sad. Скоро побачимось. See you soon.